Below me is the Pacific Undersea Gardens. For over 30 years, the Oak Bay Marine Group has been operating this floating and very unique underwater marine exhibit. Located in Victoria's Inner Harbor, it even includes an interpretive scuba diving program. If you've ever wondered about the strange and beautiful creatures that live beneath the waves, then the Pacific Undersea Gardens is a place to go. After touring the aquariums, take a seat in the underwater theater. Now these are great seats, but today I'll take you inside to where the action is.
Now those are good seats, but this is the best seat in the house. I'd like you to meet Dan St. Laurent. Dan is the assistant manager of the Pacific Undersea Gardens. Dan, exactly where are we right now?
Well, Paul, right now we're located in the Victoria Inner Harbor, and we're about 15 feet under the water surface. We're aboard an actual floating vessel, which is about 150 feet in length and about 50 feet wide. Now there's about 3,000 individual fish and other marine animals here with us today at the Undersea Gardens, including the star of our show, Armstrong, right here, our giant Pacific octopus.
Now there's fish and marine animals all around us. Can you tell us a little bit more about what we're seeing right now, Dan?
Most of the fish that are around us right now are called rockfish. Now, we don't just have rockfish here at the gardens, we've got a variety of other fish as well. You may see these little silver torpedo-like fish here like the fella in front of me, and that's one of our baby salmon. That beautiful yellow fish there was a female kelp greenling. And we also have a variety of bottom fish in here with us as well. We've got small sole, we've got capazons, Irish lords. These salmon are very, very friendly. Now we also have wolf eels, and we have octopus as well. And we have a variety of other marine life in here, including sea anemones and a variety of starfish. And we also have a variety of rockfish in here as well. Now rockfish can be easily distinguished from other fish because they have these sharp and pointy dorsal spines that are sticking out from the top of their body. Now they use these for defense. They'll actually defend themselves from seals and sea lions, and even from other fish. Now we have a beautiful specimen of a rockfish right down below here. For the most part, when they're swimming around, they keep them nicely folded down, like that fella there. But watch when our hands get closer to them. He'll either swim away very quickly, like that guy's doing, or he'll raise them up. And what he's doing, he's telling other fish, don't stick me in your mouth, because it will hurt. And it's very, very effective. Now we have some very interesting stars here at the Undersea Gardens. The divers being one of the main people that people come to see, but there's also some different fish that people like in particular. One of them is the wolf eel. Here's one right down here. You can see they're very, very friendly. They're almost like little dogs. Now they like to get their noses scratched. I'm not worried about him biting me though, he's a pretty friendly guy. Let's see if we can coax him to come out here and say hi to us today. Now these scars that you see on the forehead, that's from past domestic disputes. The males are normally the pretty mellow dudes in the relationship, and the females are the ones that normally set the tone. Now we do hand feed everything here at the Undersea Gardens, and that ensures that everything's getting well fed, and that nobody's sick. Here at the Undersea Gardens, these wolves have become my favorites because they're so friendly. What makes the waters around Victoria so diverse is the amount of plankton that's in the water. This plankton feeds all the animals on the lower scale, you know, as anemones and starfish, and they tend to attract other life like shrimp and smaller fish, which in turn are preyed on by these bigger fish. Here at the Undersea Gardens, we have guaranteed octopus sightings. For example, here's Armstrong right now. Now, it's still pretty early in the morning, so he's probably just looking for a place to bed down. Octopuses are nocturnal, which means they sleep during the day. They do most of their hunting at night, and they prey mostly on crab. They've also been known to eat scallops, and we're told in the wild they can even catch live fish. You can see right now he's actually pumping water through these gills. And this goes into the mantle cavity. Now the mantle cavity is the part that looks like his head. Now he's using these tentacles right now to walk around on the rocks. But you know, he's got another means of movement. He's actually got a form of jet propulsion. By flooding his mantle cavity, that's this part here that looks like a head, and then forcing the water through a siphon, which is located just below that, the octopus can jet away from danger at speeds of up to 20 miles per hour. Now they are a master of disguise, and they can change both their skin color and their skin texture. And they can become practically invisible to both prey and predator. Let's take a look outside, and I'll show you some of the life that's out there now. Follow me.
Although these are wild animals, OJ and Chester, a pair of playful seals, visits regularly, hoping for a few herring, knowing only too well that diver Dan has a soft spot for them. While these seals are just visitors, newborn harbor seals will soon be arriving as well, part of the Seal Pup Rehabilitation Program, Pacific Undersea Gardens manager Colin Baird explains.
Every summer, starting as early as May, but generally in June and July, as the females are harbor seals are giving birth, we end up getting in stranded or abandoned or injured harbor seal pups to our facility, which we raise and nurse back to health over a period of months and then release back into the wild. So we try to encourage people not to go out and touch the pups or get near the pups that are on the beaches, because often the mother can come back and will come back after feeding and pick up her pup.
Seal pup rehab programs, aquariums, and dive shows, a unique place to visit, the Pacific Undersea Gardens has something for everyone. For Divelog, I'm Paul Beilstein.